You started game development, and you wanted to make your dream game. Everyone on YouTube tells you to build small games first, but you started game development to make your dream game, not a bunch of random small games. I started this hobby about 8 years ago, and I learned how to approach building a dream game without the risk of failure, by making systems instead of games. A system is any single self-contained game mechanic, like an inventory, AI, or combat. This approach lets you work on your dream game by creating reusable, polished systems that you can later combine into a full game, lowering the risk of quitting or failing because you're building individual components instead of one large project. Even if you change game ideas, most of your progress carries over from game to game, so your time isn't wasted. Now, I'll explain in more detail how this approach works and how it helped me avoid wasted time, failed projects, and having nothing but half-baked games to show. The first issue we want to fix with making dream games is that you have a high risk of quitting. Dream games take an extremely long time to make. They're also really challenging and require lots of mental effort. Maintaining motivation is very important to finish a project. The thing is, you won't quit when you're having fun. Like when you just made a cool new vehicle or accomplished some other feature. You will quit when you realize, for example, that your items should be structured differently and you need to go through every part of your game where items are used and change that code. Such changes will likely break your game and give errors until you're done refactoring. At this point, if your interest levels are decreasing, you will likely just quit. You might think it's a great decision in the moment because you got a new fancy game idea. But later you realize you spent all this time and have literally nothing to show. You can't take parts of this game out to use in other games, or they have to be reworked a lot to be usable. And at this point, it is easier to start over. You also can't show anyone your game because you haven't fixed all the errors and it doesn't run anymore. This is why I haven't made any complete large games. When I started off, I tried to make a space game with procedural terrain, a sci-fi shooter game, a top-down arcade shooter game, a team checkpoint shooter game. I didn't finish any of these games. I have nothing to show for them because I didn't record videos or take screenshots while they were working. Many of these games aren't working now because I started refactoring but didn't finish, or they're half-baked because I started doing something else. I noticed this when I took computer science in university. When I met someone new and tried to get to know them, I asked questions like, "What projects have you done?" And they said, "I did this project, but it's only half finished because I stopped partway through." And when people asked me the same thing, I was like, "Oh, I have some projects, but this one doesn't compile. This one is half baked. This one is not worth the effort to polish, but I promise it was working before." This is the problem with unfinished projects that you only realize later on. You spend all this time, but you have nothing to show. Now, I did gain skills from these projects, learn new things, and had fun. But in the end, it still feels like I wasted time because building systems instead of games would have given me something cool to show and put on my portfolio. A failed game is an unfinished mess, which isn't impressive and doesn't show your skill, unlike polished systems. Now, I'll show you how the issues that come from building a large game can be solved through building systems in separate projects. First of all, systems will help you finish projects, because they focus on polishing one mechanic, like a first-person character controller or an inventory. This is far easier than completing an entire game because you're ignoring unrelated parts. For a character controller, you don't care about UI, levels, or trying to glue the character controller to other things like entering and exiting vehicles. You're only focusing on the movement. Same for the inventory. You don't care about balancing items or item icons. You're just focusing on the inventory, and you can easily add some random items just for testing. Next, systems are modular and reusable. Making a dream game will likely lead to spaghetti code because you will need to refactor things as you go, and having all the systems interacting with each other will mean changing one system requires changing others. As soon as you try to refactor something, you'll realize the way you structure your classes is not ideal, and you're stuck. You have to go through the whole project and change things up. This is just painful. This could even happen without you making any bad design choices. For example, you might initially think you just need a simple item class that has properties like damage, durability, and so on. But later, as you add more items, you realize your game needs something more complex, like backpack items to throw in inventory, or attaching items, like putting bullets in a magazine. Now, a simple item and inventory system needs to be fully rewritten, and you have to go through the whole code and change every place where items are used. Systems help you write clean code. You are forced to write modular components in every project because they're intended to be used in a different project. This way, instead of putting everything in your main class, like reading items from a file, you're forced to create a separate class. For example, an item loader class, which loads all the items at startup. Or for example, in Gota, using signals instead of functions to communicate between classes and avoid dependencies. This way, when you move your inventory system to your dream game, you don't need to modify any code, copying the code from one main class to another to make it work. You just copy the files, add the scenes, and that's it. It works. The more games you make, well, you don't even have to finish your games because you're not really making games. You're making collections of assets. So you build a personal library of systems you can use for every game going forward and even sell them on the asset store or put them on your portfolio. But don't design a system specifically for a game. Build it for the requirements of your dream game. For instance, if your game needs an inventory, ask yourself, what inventory characteristics does my game need? If it requires single slots for armor, like a dedicated helmet slot, add that to your requirements. Then you think, okay, I need an inventory system that has individual slots, can stack items, and allows dropping items. Don't think of it as, oh, I need this inventory system to support this specific item for my dream game. Keep your dream game in mind while you design the requirements and build a system for the requirements, not for the dream game. Systems also make testing and experimentation really easy. Before, when working on a game, if I add a new item, I would have to spawn in, find the item, test it, realize something is wrong, edit the code, fix the issue, run it, find the item, realize something else is wrong. It's just this loop of having to spend so much time getting to the testing in the game rather than spawning in and immediately being able to test the feature. You might think you could just add some code to make you spawn in with that item. And this may work for simpler things, but as your project grows, some things are really hard to test and you would need a specific setup for it. Having to hack your game each time just to test things or to move your player around and change spawn points, it's really tedious. In the end, you have to go back and revert all these changes to bring the game back to where it's intended to be. With systems, you don't need to do any of this. You have a specific project dedicated to a specific mechanic. When you click play, you immediately jump to testing. It's also much easier to add hacks for debugging. If you're testing an inventory, you can easily add some code to make it open to items. All the changes are kept minimal and only related to the specific mechanic. You can also experiment really easily. If you add a mechanic to your dream game and then realize it doesn't really fit, you have to go in and remove it. That also requires effort. Sometimes, if the code goes really deep, refactoring may take a long time and it'll be really boring. So you may just give up and go work on something else, which is exactly what we're trying to prevent when working on a game. Having separate projects for each mechanic allows you to easily test things and remove changes if you don't like them. Another benefit of systems is flexibility. I like jumping around inside my game. I might work on a plain controller, and if it's not going well, I get bored and can decide to go work on UI. I can easily do this in a project that has the full game, but I can do this even better with systems. But make sure to get each project to a somewhat decent level before jumping around. If you just create a new project and immediately jump, of course, you're not going to get anywhere. I now have multiple projects. If I want to test an idea for an enhancement for some mechanic, I can just open that project and test my mechanic. If I get an idea for another project, I can just jump into it and add it. I'm not limited to just working on one mechanic at a time. Whereas in a dream game, some mechanics you absolutely must work on. If your game heavily depends on combat and combat isn't working because you spend time working on UI, then that game is just unplayable. You are forced to finish combat before doing anything else. with systems, I don't have to finish anything in a set order. Now, here are some things to keep in mind before you try this. Even if you decide to build a dream game as a set of systems, you should still know how the export process works. So try exporting some of your systems, because some things will work fine while you're inside of the game engine editor, but as soon as you export a project, they may break. This may be different across game engines, but always make sure that your game works when it's exported. Finally, reframe your approach to building dream games. Instead of thinking, I want to build a dream game, ask yourself, what systems have I already built and what am I missing? Focus on building those missing systems. When you have all the systems, all you have to do is assemble the pieces into your dream game. Some effort will still be needed to make the systems talk to each other and fine-tune and build parts unique to this game. It's far easier than starting from scratch every time.